Your vision too? If not, what is your vision and what do you see as a key development challenge in Wa East? 2 minutes, you can start now.
Thank you, my brother. Let me take this opportunity to say hello to all the people of Wa East. The Sisales, I say, Bemadia. The Wales and the Gabes, I say, Niajami. To the Chakale, I say, Namadiare. I agree with my brother. Said Dana that road infrastructure is very key to the development of Wa East. But I want to disagree with him in a way because his government has been in power for the past 8 years. For the past 8 years, you cannot tell one single road that has even been cut. But the district is crisscrossed by rivers and bridges like the Kulum and the Jalo rivers. That he talked of. When I was a minister of state at the Minister of Roads, I put the Kulung and then Ambalara and all those rivers onto the American Bridges project. And the project was just about to take off when we left office. I followed this thing a number of times with the Minister for Roads, Joe Gidisu, and he assured me they were doing it, they had procured and they were doing it. Nothing has happened. I don't see how my brother now should be worried here after 8 years. They haven't done anything about our roads, and now this is the time they want to. He's thinking of doing it when he's giving the nod. No, I think that's a wrong approach. We should have seen symptoms of that before. But sincerely, when we were in government, 21 roads were cut. 21 roads were cut in the district, and we did a lot of work that we opened farmlands, roads from market centers to farmlands, and that has actually progressed the district. Because if not for what we did, the district would have even been in a very worse situation. Of course, tourism is one of the things that we have to do, and we will propagate it. Because, like he said, we have the Konkori, we have the game and wildlife bordering our district. Definitely, if we make the roads nice, I mean, these people will troop in and will reap in a lot of income.
All right. I'm grateful. But let me quickly ask you a follow-up question, because I'll get Dr. Dana to react to the issue you raised.
Yes.
Now, you agree or you concur with Dr. Dana that before you come to the district or the constituency, you have to cross into about four other areas. Yeah. Now, are you saying that, of course it is a problem, but because the NDC hasn't done it when they were, or they have not done, even though they are in power, you're saying that when you are elected, you won't see to that? Is that what you're suggesting?
I will see to that, of course. As I told you, I already put those roads or the bridges, the rivers, on the American bridge project, right, which was to be done. Unfortunately, our opponents came in and refused to do it.
So you revived that project?
Of course, of course. Of course.
Right. And you don't foresee any difficulty in reviving those projects?
There will be difficulties, but of course people are elected to overcome difficulties. If you are elected and you cannot overcome challenges and difficulties, then you are not worth it.
I'm grateful, Godfred, for your time there. But let me get Dr. Dana to react before I come to Mr. Salia. Dr. Dana, so he's suggesting that your party, your government is in power, and yet the roads are bad. And you have alluded to one that you have to cross into other districts before you get there. Is it that terrible and your government isn't working on them?
Thank you very much. I'm happy my brother agreed with me on the key issues.
Right.
But his issue is about the procedure. But let me just ask, maybe if you would see something. He was MP for 8 years. I don't know whether you agree to that.
He said he was. And yeah,
I'm coming. He was 8 years. I never had a chance to be an MP. I have never controlled command fund. If for the 4 years or the past 8 years, NDC was in power, and that I think cannot be equated that if I'm 4 years, if I'm elected, I cannot do it. Because then you can say also that if he was also MP for 8 years and he couldn't do it, what shows that if he's given 4 years, he can?
I see. I'm grateful, Dr. Dana. Godfrey, I'll give you the chance to react, okay? Just give me a minute. Let me get to Mr. Salia, and then I'll get back to you to react, because Mr. Salia wants to raise the same issue. Mr. Salia, you are the candidate of the PPP. Now, these are the issues that Dr. Dana and Godfrey are talking about: education, road, and tourism. Do you agree these are challenges, and the processes in which they have outlined to address them? Are these what you intend to do too, if given the mandate? You have 2 minutes to go through this. You can
thank
start
you, now. Thank you so much. I want to wish the people of West East the best of this Ramadan season. I agree with all of them in total, but I even believe that what they have said is an understatement of the situation on the ground. But they have just justified the reason for which I should be voted into power.
Great.
The situation is so terrible that probably we need to take you there one of these days to get the reality on the ground. I agree with them. But the other things that I think I will add to what they have said is that the youth and the women are crying for jobs. The youth that leave school are crying for jobs. There are Fulani men there that are terrorizing our people. I went to the community. A widow wept to me because she took a loan and went and plowed. The things were all right. Fulani men drove animals onto the farm, and the animals destroyed everything. We have some type of trees that is found in our place there. The government is saying we shouldn't cut the trees for even firewood. Meanwhile, they are felling these trees left, right, center, forward. And we have taken initiatives to write to the district assembly for them to stop them. Once we walk along the corridors of power, these are things that will bring to an end.
1 more minute.
Then the Galamse guys are there. We think that they should regularize their activities, put them into groups, license them. The assemblies can make revenue so that our people can get jobs to do. Because whether we do it or not, they are doing it. We don't want to encourage illegality, but we have to put them together, license them. We'll assign them that if you are working on this field, after you are done, you have to refill the place, plant trees, and move on to the next site. And I believe when we do this, we will create a lot of jobs for our people that are jobless, in addition to all that they have said.
All right, but Sally, I'm grateful for your time. You have worked within your 2 minutes, but let me do a follow-up question so that you can use all your 2 minutes. Now, the issue that Dr. Dana raised and Godfrey reacted, the fact that Godfrey has been an MP before, and he also said, well, Dr. Dana's party is in power, and so the problem should have been fixed. Now, what do you think about this issue of public officers in power, and then their inability to fix problems, and then they think that that problem will have to be resolved? Perhaps
one,
you, the PPP,
one, I want to say that you don't even need to be in power to start helping your people. Let me give an instance. We were able to associate ourselves with investment banking firms that needed to do education to educate our people to cultivate the habit of saving and investing. Now we have a lot of people in the three northern regions who are able to make a lot of returns for themselves by investing. That's one. Then two, if you look at what we call project funding, government give a lot of projects, but they don't give what we call mobilization. A lot of these contractors go around looking for funds. We have been able to write proposals to financiers, mobilize funds for them to fund these projects that the constituency is doing very well. We have over 350 contractors nationwide that we are doing, and Upper West alone has over 150 of them. And in my constituency, we have over 45 of them. I can give two instances. Funsi Secondary School Assembly Hall is a government project. When the project was given, I saw it and I was touched. So we have to look for financiers to fund this project. 2 weeks ago, I went back to the constituency. The headmaster was very happy because the project has been funded. When you ask the student, they don't even call it assembly hall. They call it entertainment hall because that is the extra use it has for them. Right. Then on the Sombisi Road, at the end of it, there's a metal bridge there that links Upper West. It links Upper West to Northern Region and Upper East. It was a project that was so major that when it was awarded, no mobilization, we had to look for financiers to do this. These are things that we have been able to do when we don't walk along the corridors of power. So you don't even need to be in power to do this. And the other thing is that they have just demonstrated why I should be voted into power. The constituency is so polarized that everything is reduced to NDC MPP. They don't work in the interest of the constituency. Things that anybody can do is either because it's MPP, NDC wouldn't do it, or it's NDC, MPP wouldn't do it. And we think that we need to unify what is, we need to unify Ghana, because with a team Ghana, we can build. We can tap resources from every side. And the same thing happens to the constituency.
More about unity. But let me quickly get Dr. Godfred Tahu to react to an issue that Dr. Danard raised. The fact that you've also been an MP before. I'm sure when Dr. Danard raised that issue, you wanted to react. So maybe some 1 minute for you to react, then we'll move on the conversation.
Thank you. It looks like my brother doesn't understand the work of an MP. Because the monies that are given to MPs are so paltry in nature that you cannot use it to do a road. What an MP can do is to lobby and lobby ministries and departments to bring infrastructure into your district. But what I have to say is that there is ample evidence. If you go through the whole of what is and ask the common man walking on the street, he will tell you what I have done. Like I've initiated, I've said about 21 rows were cut. Then student bodies, students in what is, I have on record more than 400 students that I sponsored and they went to tertiary institutions. Let me tell you that by the year 2001, you could not count up to 10 graduates in the whole of what is area. But when I took over and came into politics, I saw that was our main problem, and I started funding students to go to tertiary institutions. Today, like I said, we have more than 400 to 500 students, graduates in our district. My brother, as he said, I wonder if he has sponsored even one fellow. I don't know that. And as I said, he has not done one road. But he is a minister. A minister is a resource person, because you sit in the circle of other ministers. Whether you are minister for roads, whether you are minister for health, they are your colleagues, and you can lobby them.
All right. I'm grateful, Godfrey, for your time once again. We'll come to some of the issues that you raised, but I'm going back to the PPP candidate, Honorable Salia. We're starting a fresh conversation. This time, you raised a very critical issue about unemployment in that constituency. Even though it's been argued that members of parliament cannot or do not employ people, we're told that they have some lobbying powers that they can use to generate employment in their constituencies. Now, you raised that issue, and one key one was the issue of galamsey. You think that the activities will need to be regularized so that it can offer employment. In 2 minutes, tell me, is that thing can be done to offer jobs to the people of Wa East who are jobless at the moment?
Thank you so much. As we speak right now, my two senior brothers will attest to the fact that now we have a bank in Funsi, we have a bank in Logo, we have a bank in Bulenge. This was my personal initiative. We have partnered with some private individuals to bring a bank to this area, because hitherto there was no bank there. So all the people working there have to travel over 150 kilometers or more to go for their salary and otherwise. I am not in power, but I felt that wherever you are, whatever contribution you can make to your constituency, you should do that. And as they have all attested, it's all about lobbying, connecting with people that matter, private individuals within the country and outside the country, that can bring the relevant development to your place. That is what it is, and that is what we have done. As we speak right now, they all agree that agri is one of the key things in our area. We are lobbying with some serious philanthropists who are willing to come and construct dams for our people to do irrigation during the dry season. These are some of the things we are doing. If you look at our area there, my two senior brothers all come from one side, and that area is so rocky that if we get an entrepreneur to go and set up a quarry there, for the next 30 years, that quarry will be running. These are the things we are looking at. And some of these things, whether you are in power or not, you can do them. But you will only be better endowed if you are in power and you are able to use the state purchasing power. The state machinery can give you more advantage. But if you are incapacitated to do this, they can even make you the president, you still cannot do it. That is why I think that, for me, they should all let us team up and let's get this done. and stop this polarization of NDC, MPP, because that wouldn't help the constituency. What we need to do is that they are all wonderful people. They all have wonderful brains. Let's put these brains together and see how we can develop the place. You mustn't become an MP or a minister. In any case, they have all been there. So if they have all been there, this blame game do not really work well for us. It's best that we sit down and let's say, look, what is that is the food basket of Upper West.
Right.
If you see the quantum of food that come from West East to West Central, you'll be amazed.
Okay.
But the road network is terrible, we need to team up and get this done.
I am grateful. I'm grateful for your time there. Dr. Dana, so the issue of unemployment is key here. Mr. Salia has raised several avenues he thinks can be used to generate and create employment, even when you're not in power. But he thinks that when you're in power, your chances of creating those jobs are brighter. What do you think about job creation in Y East? 2 minutes, you can start now.
Yeah, first of all, let me say that there's a reason why we have elections.
Mm.
There's a reason why we have parliament, representation. And when you are elected and you are given the nod, you are expected to do what? Perform certain functions. And for the people who what elected you. So having the power is to enable you discharge. So
right.
I think it's important that we take note of that.
Mm.
And then I also want to say that I think it's sometimes we hit too much and unnecessarily on this NDC-MPP divide. Look, a good Muslim is a good Christian. A good Christian is a good Muslim. A bad Muslim is a bad Christian. They are all the same God. If you deliver to the people who sent you, I think that if you are NDC or MPP, the other party may not like it, but deep in their hearts, I'm God. They will know. So I think we are getting there.
Right.
Then to say that the employment, as I said, the issues are linked. If you have a good road network, those who are familiar with the history of our area, some time ago it was 2 exit points. You could come through Tambali, through Dabonya, through that side of our district he talked about, the rocky side, and then to what? Now, because of the game and the new creation of the new road through the Solar Tuna, we are now like a backyard. So it's only one way to work. And you cannot develop without some kind of, gateway. And when that happens, it will affect the job situation.
Mm.
I think that is why I started from the roadmap. And the farming. He touched on certain things about the environment, cutting down of trees. In fact, that's dear to my heart. Our grandfathers were proud of 2 things. The land they had to farm and the hunting the animals. The animals are not in the game. The land, if we allow the land to cut down the trees, where do we go to? So I think it was something I'll be interested to, if I'm elected, to make sure that there is some law enforcement.
1 more minute.
Now, getting back to the issue about what the quantum. You see, if you are given 8 years or 4 years, you may think you have done a lot. Well, yes, it may be true. And we have it has to be acknowledged that you did something. But how do you know that if somebody else is given that thing, he will not do more? I've finished.
I'm grateful, Dr. Dana, for working within your time. But you have just about 30 seconds. I want you to quickly address this before I let you go. Now, Salia raised the issue of the constituency being the food basket. And yet, he thinks that it is unable to do that because of certain hitches, certain obstacles. How do you intend to deal with this? Yes, Dr. Dana, I was talking to you, referring to what Salia said about the fact that the constituency is a food basket of the Upper East, and yet several obstacles are hindering the constituency playing this role. And I'm asking, in 30 seconds, how perhaps you intend to deal with this? He mentions particularly the road sector.
Yes, that's why I told you the issues are linked. Once you, in the Y East, you are able to get this road thing dealt with, you virtually open the way. And it will lead to the employment, it will help, in movement. And so I think that he has made a point about the food basket. And that's why I am worried, and I believe they are all worried, about the fact that they are cutting down trees. He mentioned it. The last tree dies, the last man dies.
Okay.
And what I'm saying is that is our asset, our land. We have some of the best land in the area, the region. So when we lose it, where do we go to? So, okay. But my aim will be to, you know, sensitize the people.
I'm grateful.
Yeah. You know, the knowledge is power. Sometimes they don't know. And when you make them to know, they would fight to protect the land.
I'm grateful, Dr. Dana, for that answer. Let me go to Godfrey. Let's start from here. We're still on the issue of unemployment. And Salia has raised certain key issues. He said he can even lobby if he's not in power. Dr. Dana is suggesting that open up the constituency and that will create the jobs. Godfrey, in 2 minutes, how do you intend to use your lobbying power as a member of parliament to help the people of Wa East to get jobs?
Thank you very much. I have already done a lot, and I will do a lot more if I'm given the chance. Like I told you, if you have people who haven't gotten education, it becomes difficult, especially for the formal sector, to absorb them. And that was why I pursued education rigorously when I was member of parliament. And as I said, more than 400 to 500 people go to tertiary institutions. Because if you don't give them education, how do they offer themselves to be employed by, especially the formal sector and even the private sector? Mm. So I will continuously pursue education and send more of our boys and girls to institutions, because some of them now have become nurses, some of them have become teachers, and all the in all the professions. So definitely, if you give people chance in education, they will get employment by themselves. Mm. Then also, our 90% of our people are farmers, and as farmers, they do the traditional crops of yam, maize, and guinea corn, which is not much fetching in terms of money. What I have noticed of late is that a few farmers have started undertaking certain, like the grafted mongoose. And I looked at it and saw that if we come to a time where every farmer in the world is has at least an acre of grafted mongoose, that would be mean a lot to them.
One more minute.
And that apart, we also have what this watermelon of late also coming. So that is an area, if we develop it, the farmers will change their fortunes. So that is why I think that when I become an MP, I will make sure that I use my common fund now to sponsor some of the farmers to be able to set up at least pilot plots, so that within a short time, the thing will expand and it will become commercial and cash crops for the people.
Mm. Godfrey, I am grateful for your time. Godfrey Tang is the NPP aspiring candidate for Wa East constituency. Now, let's move on to this key issue that Mr. Salia raised about working together as Team Ghana. Mr. Salia, I'm starting with you, yes. Because assuming that the PPP candidate, you get elected as the representative of Wa East constituency, and the government isn't from your party, how do you intend to, in this case I want details, intend to work with the NPP candidate, the NDC candidate, and any other candidate, as well as the district assembly, to ensure that unity is in Wa East, development is done in unison with all the ideas that these persons have? Let's talk about unity and development in 2 minutes.
I think that I will throw an open hand to them. One, appreciating the fact that we all come from Wa East. Two, appreciating the fact that we are all working in the interests of Wa East. And three, appreciating the fact that God has endowed each and every one of us with a different skill and different knowledge. And with this, we need together to build a place. That is why I'm surprised that some of us here are disputing the fact that there is this polarization factor. I went to a community to do a program. The next day, my two senior brothers' parties went there and they were fighting. And you can't develop when you are fighting among yourself. And it was basically because of who should host the program where. And I was seriously taken aback. But if we come together as a team, we all have different skills, different knowledge. That is what we need to bring together and look at what is good for the constituency and not with the individuals or the parties involved. So I believe that there are a lot more human resources from Wa East, both within and outside the country. We need to throw an invitation to all of them. They are very wonderful entrepreneurs from the place, both within and without. Those are the things we need to do to get the place developed. Then also, I think that once we are able to get to the district assembly, partner with them, let them know the kind of agendas that they should add to what they are already practicing. Because there is something that is going on. My brothers talked of paying fees and all those. It's good to look at education, but you can't be funding it from your own coffers. You can do it more when we have very established ways of getting people to have their own money. Because if you teach somebody how to fish, it's better than fishing for the person. What if you are not there, how then do the person fish? But if we teach them how to make money for themselves, how to do it, we are not saying that everybody can do it. There will be others that will be less privileged, and we have to support them, and we are doing it. I believe they will all be amazed if I mention the number of people that I'm caring for through school. I know we all do it, but we should have a well-established means of doing it. And we can only do that when we teach the people how to look for money for themselves. And once you teach them how to fish, whether you are there or not, they'll be fishing for themselves. Once we get what is appropriate and what is supposed to be done in the constituency, whether we are there or not, they'll be doing it, because the youth are looking after us. The youth are crying for jobs. This is something we can't run away from.
I'm grateful, Salia, for your 2 minutes there. Let me come to Dr. Dana. Do you agree, as Salia said, that there is indeed polarization in what is constituency? And if elected, how do you intend to deal with it, bringing on board the other candidates who might have contested against you and lost? In any case, if you don't win too, how do you intend to also deal with this issue of polarization, if indeed it is in the constituency? 2 minutes, you can start.
Thank you very much. Let me just explain something. I don't think anybody will deny that the polarization isn't there. What I mean to say is that it's something that can be overcome. That's why I made the point that a good Christian is a good Muslim. What is leadership about? Leadership is about helping people overcome problems. And so you are supposed to do things that one other person cannot do. So it is for, if elected, definitely the success and the state match of my leadership will depend very much on my ability to contain. I think that's what it is. In the end, we are serving one. My aim is that long after we are dead and gone, the question will be, what did we do? So that is how I see it. So it's very important that if you are a leader and cannot bring on board, have a big heart, then I think it's not good leadership. So there, you can I can say that emphatically, that that's one of the cornerstones. In fact, that's how I've always operated. And even in chieftaincy, if you don't have this, believe me to be, you can never succeed. And I've been in the institution, I know what it is. So that is the way we should go. Whether NDC, MPP, PPP, the issue should be the people. And the Bible says, for the lack of knowledge, the people perish. And we have a similar thing in the Quran. So we should, if elected, my aim is the good name. That is the essence of it. So that's how I see it. The leader must initiate the of course, there will be some, try as hard as you can, they wouldn't come on board. But you should make the effort, and once you get those that will come with you, you move for the benefit of where is.
I'm grateful, Dr. Dana, for your time. Godfrey, in 2 minutes, share with us the issue of polarization. Some suggestions have been made. How do you intend to lead the process to unite where is and get them to speed up development?
Thank you. I have long started uniting the people of Wa East. Because if you go to Wa East now, you ask NDC, MPP people, they will tell you that Tango is the person who will not act on the basis of parties. There are many, many NDC students that I have sponsored because I think they are from Wa East and not because they are in NDC or whatever. There are all other party members, as far as I know, that you are a student from Wa East and desirous to pursue a career, a help. So that is where we must start from. We must forget that somebody belongs to NDC and somebody belongs to MPP or the other parties. So in that bit, what we have to do is to forget about these party differences and unite our forces. Because my brother here, he says he's a very big time lawyer. I'm a teacher by profession. He's a banker. I think if the three of us will bring our minds together, definitely we will be able to. But unfortunately, that has not been the character of some of our people. But as I tell you, the present DC for WA was my friend before he became a DC, even though he's an NDC. Tell him anytime I get to the district capital, I make sure I go to his house and we sit down and we do things together. The sitting MP, even though he defeated me under some circumstances, yet he's still a very good friend of mine.
Right.
But let me tell you one thing. Even within the NDC as of now, my brother here,
Dr. Dana.
Dana, is having serious problems with his sitting MP. They are all over. Number of times the party structures have moved to the district to try to solve this problem. They are unable to solve it. Okay. Why is it so that people should belong to the same party?
I'm grateful for your time. And I'm sure Dr. Dana won't react to what you said, that he has problems in his party. Gentlemen, I'm grateful for your time. I'm going to give you 1 minute to speak in any of the local dialects from WA's constituency, telling your constituent they should give you their mandate for you to represent them in Parliament on November 7, and then we wrap up our conversation. Starting with you, Mr. Salia of the PPP.
So, what is the name? Mamine, Ayida Mbaja. Tijirine, Babo Tenkara. Blanet na song, ka tepalu ni yu Tenkara. Party yala nane, bure yala nane, jin yala nane, titungbangoni yala Tenkara. Bama ja weng, awa moya nye ni yu. Pampana to be believed into Posari and Mamba High School. Yamanya Banyo, you are a Babatar to me. To no number can now, Chenya and anything peel it. To you a bank funsing, are you a Kangabuling, are you a Kangalogon? To no Yalan and Tobacco, and Dora Beach, a bank unto Kubon. I party Yalanan, canane to party me. To the Conde, I altering a wanana. Share a party now, wanana. To no Yalanka, to Yalanella, near net and a bank he are. What is at one bonoba and a bang a one sombo carpalo new you? Anna Dimetumbora. So ting a caresonte, carason carpalo new you. Anna knitting them peeling the yan.
I'm grateful, Salia. Goffy, okay, so 1 minute you can address your constituent in any of your local dialect.
Before I do that, let me correct something.
Okay.
I've seen certain figures being displayed. I think your figures are wrong.
Okay, the election figures?
Yes, because I won.
We'll correct that.
I won in 2004 and 2008.
Okay.
My figures couldn't be lower than the NDC.
I'm told corrected, I'm grateful.
Yes.
Please go ahead.
Mbamine, Mamine, Mantang, Lejincha, Akuna Kuriye. Ka, Yajanya, Yumana, Ampara. Tinga, Kadivoti. And now, Babiao. To vote soon. Kabelavian, Kakianga pet near ja and be what is sing. Ananimine man the man recurie. Tomahen the man tung what is sink near jaba man. Abalatuna. Ndomine, Kinan quarter yoka, yomba mana. Eba mantari. Emanda, emantara, yoya ga, yo jala. Ajung, tijin and a tinginny. Pianga near jaj, Sarayanka, Pianga pen, nsali, be ja, and be especially what is sing. Ajung. Na ngun le yoya so rukuti kare dia te mi he ajun ye ha dindinge ke da adaran wata ne ja ga to vote kuro nana adodon kwa akufu ado aga to vote kuro gofre bayon tango ye nun kore ni yamban abanka ka yelun won ye kanga oman dia yan ne ya baraka.
I am grateful, Godfrey. Dr. Dana, you have the last voice. You speak to them and let them know why they should give you their mandate.
Jama, I what is never a chela program, be a car program. Yala gramma mania, yala dole, yale, and Dora Salia, then yaw a tango and yellow one langa. Maya anjinga, Bamada Laman Boraka way MP. I didn't know one. Gave vote kumo. The can in Bialaman in yala, Yakumo voca in yala. Near a tangled down a banana in a, but yen yen ya. kaba yewo blana ba eta mayan komba yala nyana na ban yala o mentro komba yala nyana na ban yala mayan yalla nga no bi yemba sura salin jiyara manda bora kai kuvu kamen e karnye yala yala bla.
I am grateful. Dr. Henry Sedu Dana is the NDC aspiring parliamentary candidate for the Wa East constituency. Godfrey Bayon Tang is the NPP parliamentary candidate for the same constituency, Wa East. And Bart Salia is representing the PPP come November 70, asking for your mandate to go to parliament. Gentlemen, I'm grateful for your time this morning.